Good day. I am by name Dimlong Hannah, an English studies teacher of JSS 1. I'll be making a presentation on developing and using multimedia-based teaching materials. I'll be using a case study of English studies. Developing and using multimedia-based supplementary teaching materials in model education, a case study of English studies. For this presentation, we'll be focusing on four areas. The table of contents, we have introduction, we'll be looking at introduction, supplementary teaching materials, multimedia supplementary teaching materials, and then examples of tasks and activities, suggestions of these tasks and activities that can be used in line with the supplementary, multimedia supplementary teaching materials, and then we'll be concluding. Okay. For so many teachers and learners of English language, particularly second or foreign learners of English language, teaching and learning of the language becomes boring and uninteresting, because quite often you find out that teachers themselves present this language in words, sentence patterns, grammar, and it becomes so mechanical. As a result, people come to think of teaching of grammar as a monotonous job. But a resourceful and imaginative teacher can be so creative in breaking this monotony by using innovative techniques and authentic multimedia-based supplementary materials. So in this presentation, we attempt to present or demonstrate how jokes, anecdotes, stories, and situations, including pictures, how these things can be effectively exploited in teaching English studies. Now, as language teachers, even I myself feel most at times that the texts prescribed are not sufficient. Most times they don't contain variety of purposes involved in teaching language. So we find them inadequate, with some areas of communicative needs of the learners. It is now this multimedia-based supplementary teaching materials that can bridge this gap. Therefore, we are going to review two sessions, as I mentioned earlier on. We'll be looking at this multimedia-based supplementary teaching materials and some suggestive description, material-wise, tasks and activities for classroom application. Multimedia-based supplementary teaching materials. The list of these multimedia-based supplementary teaching materials are quite inexhaustible. We have them around us, so many around us. If whereby one cannot Google, when you're not in the position, you cannot Google to get these materials and print them out, we have concrete materials that can be used. Now, these materials include jokes, short stories, anecdotes, cartoons, pictures, newspaper articles, concrete materials, public speeches, television programs, and so on. Ishihara and Chi in 2004 point out that learners seem to be better motivated about language learning when new and exciting materials are being used. Thus, by exploiting this natural fascination for these new materials, an instinctive opposition to routine and monotony, like the way it is normally done, a better learner motivation and participation can be ensured when one makes use of these materials. Okay, let's look at instances and suggestions on how these materials these supplementary materials can be used in teaching. For instance, we have an example, use of anecdotes. Now, anecdotes are short stories or amusing stories about real persons or events. They are generally simple and easy to understand. The moral of such stories can be understood only by reading between the lines. Now, in the case of such materials, activities that can be introduced using these anecdotes will help in enriching the student's thinking, feeling, and sensibility. Anecdotes can be effectively used for the purpose of tests. They can also be used for role play and drama activities, particularly in teaching literature. Now we have the use of stories and situations of crisis. Here I'll be presenting a lesson on collective nouns. And in the course of this presentation, I'll be making use of these stories to teach collective nouns. And then we also have another material, use of cartoons or pictures. Now, cartoons are drawings that are exaggerated. Mostly the physical features, the action or quality of a person or thing depicted. They are exaggerated in a way that learners can be able to see these features, identify them, get attracted to them, and develop interest in learning what those pictures are about. Now you can find pictures, you can cut out pictures, you can print out pictures, and take out the caption. And how do you now engage these learners? You do that by asking the learners to write out what they think the pictures are trying to depict. This particular one activity can be used as a warm-up for the class. Keywords can be blanked out of the pictures, and children can be asked to write out what the picture portrays. Okay, I'll be presenting, as I said, a lesson on collective nouns. How can we make use of these multimedia supplementary teaching materials in teaching English studies, particularly in model education? Collective nouns. Now, collective nouns are types of nouns that defines a group of things, people, animals. Just as we know nouns. Collective nouns are a way of defining nouns that appear in groups. And these nouns include things, animals, and persons or people. Examples of collective nouns, as I said, they group things, persons, or animals. For instance, we have things. And here's a picture displaying things that appear in group and words to use to describe these things. For instance, we have a tube of toothpaste. We have a piece of jewelry. We have pile of money. Then we have a set of tools. Now, how do we engage these students? These words, these keywords, or the captions under each of these pictures can be blanked out. And the students would be asked to identify the collective nouns by their terms, by the correct or appropriate terms. And then we have examples as well. We have collective nouns for people, a gaggle of comedians. We have a giggle of girls, a glozing of taverners. We have a helix of geneticists. We have a host of angels. We have a house of senators. We have a number of mathematicians. Now you can see if students are being engaged in having to think of the appropriate name that will suit each of these collective nouns, then the class becomes creative and interesting. Aside from pictures and prints, cartoons, I earlier mentioned that we can equally use concrete materials which we find around us. For example, this is an example of a collective noun, a pair of shoes. Another example is a bunch of keys. Now, these are things we can find, these are things that are at our disposal. We can easily find them around us. In conclusion, we can, however, see that teaching English studies can be made very interesting, amusing, and captivating if teachers of English studies, particularly, can make use of these multimedia-based supplementary teaching materials. Now, when this we develop this and we use them in carrying out our teaching, then it will provide the basis for a meaningful, real language learning through interesting and extended use of various supplementary materials. This will, however, enable the learner to become more motivated and active in learning, and the learners will be willing to participate. Also, the strategic use of authentic materials in teaching of English will help teachers keep the curriculum relevant and meet the needs of today's learners, particularly in the case of model education. I hope we have learned something on developing and using multimedia-based supplementary teaching materials, particularly in model education and in English studies as a case study. Thank you for listening.